Ako si Fred Serrano. Ang full name ko ay Segfredo Roque Serrano. Ako ay isang undersecretary sa Department of Agriculture. Ako yung in charge ng policy and planning, project development, R&D at saka regulations. Yung regulatory policy ng biotech ay responsibility ko rin yan. Modern biotechnology is a very important option, not only in agricultural production but in many areas of the economy. Dahil wala na tayong lupa eh. Problema yung lupa, meron na tayong problema sa ibang resources, maliit na yung forest cover natin, we need intensification of technology to make land more productive. Doon ang strength ng biotechnology. Genetically modified corn that has made our corn farmers more productive, primarily because they were no longer susceptible to the Asian corn borer, which can eat up 40% of the harvest when you have a very heavy pest pressure. Naging very productive sila. In fact, we are now, how many? Almost 80-90% ng ating feed corn is actually GM corn. Napababa natin yung cost. Yung domestic corn natin became competitive with imported corn. And therefore, corn became affordable to our livestock industry. I think, as I have always said, genetically modified corn, at least those that made and passed our standards, are the single most important technological development that saved the livestock industry in this country. Importante na mag-invest tayo sa research. Wala nang argument na nakakatulong yan sa increasing productivity, no? And even making us, our products and the environment, safer for as long as we do our job in the regulatory system. So, ang sinasabi ko, hindi dapat maiwan yung regulatory system mo doon sa technological development. Kasi ang magre-regulate ng teknolohiya at saka kung paano ito gagamitin, paano ito pupunta sa ating mga pamilihan, ay yung regulatory system. Ang importante dyan, you have to realize that this is a very powerful technology. It's very dynamic. For the young people, especially for those enrolled in the Ag Biotech program of the universities like UPLB, I would encourage you to do very well. But it's also important for you to be grounded. It's important for you to connect with our farmers, connect with industry, connect with consumers and learn their concerns. But do not lose yourself in all of that. As I've said, what is important is that we are able to maintain the objectivity of science. No? Yun ang arbiter, hindi yung pamahiin, hindi yung takot. Remember, kung wala na tayo, kukunti na yung lupa, may problema sa tubig, kukunti na yung resources natin, ang infinite resources natin yung utak ng mamamayan natin. So, yung mga scientists natin, you have a lot of gray matter in between your ears. Use that so that you can fulfill your mission for our people. And it's very important we all do our job, but it's also important that we become more innovative and imaginative. Itong ginagawa natin every last week of November. Pero ano lang ito eh, observance lang. Parang katulad ng ano yung Pasko eh, di ba? December 25, although contested pa rin whether pinanganak si Jesus Christ ng December 25 o September, di ba? Parati nating sinasabi, kahit na isang araw lang yung Pasko, dapat the way we treat our fellows, the way we do our jobs, the way we behave as human beings, the way we treat nature and the environment should be the same as before. Walang no slackening, no, in our efforts. So for the National Biotech Week, the message is, let's keep on doing this. Let's keep on trying to explore the frontiers of the technology so that it will be of better service, we could be of better service to our people. Bioteknolohiya para sa kalikasan, kalusugan, kagandahan, kabuhayan, kaunlaran. Lamang na lamang ang masa at magsasaka sa 5K ng bioteknolohiya.